Hi guys, as usual it's me, Justin off-screen voice, and you're watching Review Machines. This time we have for review something very unusual. You see on your screens Duha iTank, the newest electric scooter that consists of many quite interesting engineering solutions. Well, this thing is worth our attention even in stock, but this scooter was completely modified. Now it's not just an electric scooter, it's a real reckless electric cannon. But first of all, let's talk a little about iTank in a standard version. Duha iTank is a project funded by Kickstarter. It was kindly welcomed by the audience and the required sum was gathered very quickly, significantly ahead the schedule. Most of all, people liked this futuristic and very unusual design. I should say, I also was impressed by the look of iTank. A very bright design with some cyberpunk motifs. It's a real eye-stopper that attracts a lot of attention wherever it goes. Besides the look, it's also interesting by the construction. In standard, it's equipped with a motor wheel 2 kW. It provides 50 km per hour maximum speed and a range of 50 km. Two front wheels look greatly and moreover, they provide stability on the road and more effective brakes. As I've mentioned, today we have a scooter which is far from being in stock. It was significantly modified in a tuning studio of electric transport. First of all, the standard motor wheel was removed and changed for much more powerful electric motor. Instead of 2 kW motor, now we have here 7.5 kW one. Consequently, now there is a chain drive and the capacity of the battery was improved twice. After such a modification, the maximum speed is more than 100 km per hour. And the range seriously increased, now it's up to 100 km with a smooth driving. Then we have here an improved suspension, shocks, dashboard and some other stuff. In the long run, the scooter now is much more powerful, fast and reliable. Today we have tested this scooter for the first time. And to tell the truth, I'm really impressed. Now it's really an effective transport, and I think the customer will be very satisfied. Well, it's high time to have a ride, isn't it? Any other serious electric bike, it may surprise you by its quietness and smooth power. The other day we made a video about electric Yamaha, you might have seen it. So I knew about the possibility of electric bike and it was difficult to surprise me this time. Nevertheless, the bright design of this scooter together with its performance impressed us quite seriously. It's very stable on road, quite predictable and so responsive to a throttle. The stability on road results from the unusual three wheels design. Two front wheels absorb and equilibrate all the roughnesses and provide smooth riding. By the way, I suppose that such a construction with two front wheels provides more safety. If one of the two wheels, for example, runs into a hole, the bike will keep stable unlike a regular bike. The front wheels have a travel 180 mm relative to one another, so theoretically it's able to overcome some obstacles with such height. Well, and now let's find out the maximum speed of the scooter. As you can see, the scooter hit 70 km per hour just for 6 seconds. It was rather dangerous to go faster there, but I suppose that it's able to do 0 to 100 in less than 10 seconds. I think it's a good result for an electric scooter. When I rode it myself, the thing I liked is how it behaves on the road. I'm not a pro rider, but it seemed to me that it was so stable and predictable. Besides, I really felt the power of electricity here, smooth power. Then it produces an impression of high quality bike. Nothing here is creaking and dangling. In my mind, iTank will be a perfect transport in small towns, where your daily rides are within 70 km to be consistent with the range of the scooter. In this way it's almost ideal. Little maintenance, reliable, almost noiseless, no exhaust, eco-friendly. And the most important advantage, that it doesn't need fuel, and electricity nowadays is much cheaper. By the way, due to the suspension with 3 wheels, it's rather stable not only on a flat road, but even on rough ground in parks, for example. And I think it's interesting to mention the prices. The price of a standard version is about $3,000. But if you want a modified version, like you saw in this video, it will cost $3,000 more. Well guys, please leave comments what you think about this scooter I tuned, and if it's worth to convert it into a more powerful electric version. And now let's call it a day. Thanks for watching guys, please subscribe the channel if you like this video. It will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.